All right. Wow, what a roller coaster that was,
crazy,
Michael.
Crazy.
Crazy action, crazy technical difficulties, and just, yeah, I mean, the tech team, you know, they got the satellite truck out, and we actually brought in some people from NASA and some Google people in here to resolve work on the issues we're having.
Yeah, so the action was going on, huh? So
I know, but
we saw Felix Martinez winning over Alberto Rondina.
So yeah, give us a recap. I was
was a very bad heat for Alberto Rondina. He crashed a lot in the beginning, kind of lost a lot of energy there. And yeah, Felix Martinez from the Dominican Republic had a good heat, and he won clearly. And then the last heat was Jacobs against Da Silva, and it was a very close heat. Mark Jacobs won by 0.1, as far as I know, saw. And now we have Renan Romeo from Brazil against Borisov, Sergey Borisov from Russia. Should be an interesting heat too. But I talked to the riders during our little break, and they said the conditions are really harsh with a lot of chop out there. Even if you think you have the trick perfect, you still can crash in the landing. Because the waves are everywhere and you lose the balance and flip over or get a butt check in. So it's difficult.
I can imagine. It seems like we've got a little less wave action as well than we had in the days prior.
So I think the wind chop is can unfold even more than the last days when we had like a little wave coming in.
Yeah, it kind of would allow a little bit of a flat water section in between some of those waves, but not so much today.
Back to blind from Borisov, but not too high. Borisov on his 13, and I think Renault already changed for a smaller kite. Don't know exactly, but the kite looks definitely smaller and pulled a little mope now.
There we are. All right, we got the scores up. If you guys are wondering, I've got any friends who are trying to watch the stream and can't on the live page, we apologize. We think it's actually a problem with YouTube. But you're going to have to go straight to our YouTube channel. I just posted the link to Facebook where you can watch it.
Nice Aspen 3 from Renan Romeo out there. Right now I would put him in the lead. Let's see what the judges say.
Definitely he's got a few nice tricks under his belt. Three tricks landed.
Borisov only one actually. That's court. So yeah, but the heat is still fresh, still young. And you only need 5 tricks. So let's see how it goes. Some beginner lessons in the heat area right now. Huh?
Oh, yeah. Someone getting their first rides in the middle of a peak area.
Let's see what you can score.
All right. There you go.
Front blind board from Borisov.
Board in front of you. They are definitely right in the middle of the box. Sure if you caught that, but that's pretty funny.
Yeah.
There they go.
Not for the two guys that are in the heat right now and like kind of want to go around them. Huh?
Yeah, I'm sure there's...
Oh, now it crashes even a kite now.
You got to feel not super cool, I think, at that point.
Yeah, I don't know. NS5 from Borisov out there. Renault going for a front mope. Ooh, but a big crash.
Definitely Borisov needed that one, I think. Yeah. That front blind came in pretty good for Borisov, but now definitely a solid lead for Renault from Brazil. So if you're just joining us, we are into our... resumation, if that's even a word, of the double elimination here in Panama. Renault Remy from Brazil versus Sergey Borisov from the Russian Federation. That is Renault right there.
Going for a Hinterberger pass. Ooh, nicely landed on the chop, but he could pull it off. Borisov looking really powered on his kite. Double Aspen pass, but landed just on the back. That hurts.
Sergey definitely has some solid potential. Sometimes he puts together really nice heats.
Yeah.
Sometimes he kind of comes like unglued, but definitely...
I mean, that happens. Huh? It's like sometimes the little things change a lot, and sometimes you land the first trick really good and you feel so happy and safe about it, everything else comes easy, and sometimes you crash the first trick and everything is gone, your whole concept, and you kind of have a mind block. Hinterberger pass from Serge right now.
Down at the bottom of the box out of our view. But there's Renault nice with a mob.
He had the mob already. I think he was going for the mob 5. But it's difficult with the takeoff here as well, with the chop everywhere. It's you need a really clean takeoff to take out the good tricks, and it's difficult right now. Nevertheless, the guys pull really good tricks, huh?
Oh yeah, nice.
Here's
front
a nice front mope. Kite low.
Definitely one of my favorite tricks. I think it just looks...
Unfortunately seen less and less, huh?
I know. I mean, there was definitely some people who have some big, massive front mopes that just go, you know, really high.
Yeah, Renault was one of them. Maury is one of them. Maury Rodwald. And yeah, Kevin Langer, who we really miss here, also was a guy for the big front mopes.
What is up with Kevin? He decided to stay in Cape Town after...
Yeah. He's in love with the waves, in love with his stand-up paddleboard as well. Lots of kiting, but yeah. He got king of the air in Cape Town in Big Bay. Ooh. Now the Mope 5 from Reno here. And yeah, he's enjoying life.
Well, I hope he tunes in at some point, see what's going on, say hello. But he came back pretty good after his injury. He came back and he was definitely bumping
up. Solid riding, definitely, yeah. But he told me, I met him in Cape Town, he told me he's going to come back for sure for some events. But this one just didn't fit in his schedule.
What was that from Renault? Did he take off from
it
the toe side?
It was a chromo, but kind of weird movement there. But yeah, it was a chromo.
At this distance right now, I really have a hard time seeing when people are actually taking off toe side. Kind of
double S bent to blind from Borisov, but another bad crash there.
Going down.
With only 20 seconds left and a big lead from Renault. It's going to be very difficult for Sergei.
How are we doing on time?
15 seconds left, so I'm afraid that's it, as Sergei is still swimming with his kite on the beach.
Well, these guys are...
5 seconds left. Now or never, Sergei. It's a 6-point trick. Oh, no.
Oh, setting up and...
Just too early for Sergei.
Little too late for our...
But yeah, now he went for it. But there's another competitor. So, that's it for the first guys round.
So, that's it for the first guys. Let's get the flow going, man. We've just kind of been, you know, getting yanked around, technical difficulties, and just all sorts of stuff. But just
looking good now, huh?
Say hello to everyone and welcome you guys back. Hopefully, you've been tuning in over the past couple days. Been got to see some of the action that unfolded yesterday and the day before. But yeah, here we are, day 3 of the event, I think. And
the wind was on every day, so. Pretty lucky, pretty happy, huh?
Definitely been really lucky. Today was actually really lucky because we didn't have to get up so early.
Yeah,
so
that was good.
Definitely pretty happy.
But yeah, still I managed to get up at 6:30 because with the jet lag from home.
Oh, really?
Still like kind of in the Austrian time zone.
That can play havoc on a competitor. That's can be pretty challenging to show up in an event, be jet lagged, and have to get up, pump your kites up. Yeah.
Here it helped, actually, because, we had some 6:30 skippers meetings, and then you're, like, if you're, like, waking up at 5 anyway, you're pretty fit at 6:30.
Well, it's definitely been some long days. We got heat started yesterday at 7 a.m., and we finished just around after 6:30. So
same on the first day. So
not a short day by any means. So hopefully, definitely...
Well, yeah, but better like that than there would be no wind at all. So
this is true. This is true. But they were calling, you know, maybe for a day or two without wind, but it looks like we're going to have wind all the way through the event.
Yeah. Still, Eric, our race director, kind of wants to pull it through as soon as possible to have it in the bag.
Yeah, because
you never know, huh?
Yeah, you definitely never know. And I think, I mean, we should if everything goes as planned, we should be able to get through the doubles today. Huh?
Yeah, yeah. And but you know, you have what you have, and if there is no win tomorrow, the day after tomorrow, you're safe.
We've got a second discipline, and it's pretty cool. Have you heard the?
Haven't heard so far.
Okay, that's
news.
It's still a secret of the format of the second discipline. So we're gonna try and cover that and bring that to you live too. So if you're interested in some interesting, I don't know what, I can't even describe it without giving it away. So I'm just gonna leave it at that and just say stay tuned. We'll put it in the press release and on Facebook so you guys will know what's going on. But interesting format for a competition. It's going to involve all your favorite riders doing some really cool stuff. So do stay with us for that.
So in the first ladies' heat is on.
Shifting gears over to the ladies.
We have Helena Prochotska on the water. And she's riding against...
She's riding against... Lammerts,
nice.
From Deutschland. From she's a Dutch rider from Holland.
Nice. So European heat here.
Annelies Lammerts. She's a young girl and riding really well. I was pretty impressed watching her earlier rounds. Definitely good to see a new face.
Yeah, she's definitely not holding back. Risking it all, going for it.
So how do you pronounce Helena's last name?
I don't know exactly. I think it's Prochotska.
Prochotska, okay. Yeah. I should know that because I'm, yeah.
1/30 Polish?
Someone in my family came from Poland. But I don't have the mastery of the language or pronunciation, so I call her
Helena Beats.
We're
going to ask her later.
Ooh,
nice Aspen to blind.
Lammerts. Kite coming down, getting it without kite clipping the water.
Nice cut control there, and should score pretty good for her. Looked nice.
Definitely. I think she's going to give Helena a run for her money.
Definitely. Helena charging for something. Aspen to blind as well. Ooh, she passed it, but...
Good takeoff, but...
She leaned back too much, kind of... Landed on the back in the end. She still has time to make another try on that one.
Ooh, Lammert's kite's getting a little high, getting away from her. Couldn't keep her arm
couldn't
square
hold that, yeah.
in the square of her back. We have a delivery of a Red Bull. Thank you. A lovely Red Bull girl. They've been taking really good care of us here at Nitro City. We've pretty much got Travis Pastrana's suite up here that we're broadcasting from. So
now she landed her Aspen to blind. Helena, so it's a close heat so far, huh?
It is. It's going to be a doozy. This is a... Man, I really love it when these girls are just fired up and going for it. As Lammerts gets it that time.
Kind of a back roll to wrapped.
Kite a little high, but definitely a hard trick. And
she's going to score high with that. So far, yeah, Helena scored like around a 7 with her Aspen to blind. She scored around 5 with a blind church.
Lammerts just threw, I think it was a Rayleigh wrap. I'm not sure. Or no, it was a... I think it was just a blind judge, actually, but...
She had a blind judge on the first trick already.
Did she?
But she's in a lead right now, so, yeah.
Let's see what that...
Back to blind.
That was a back to blind. Okay.
Also kind of difficult with the sun coming down more and more. The water reflects just in our direction. Huh?
Wow.
Kind of taking the sight.
Oh!
Ooh, going for the NIS there.
Lammerts is giving her. This is pretty impressive heat
right now.
Also
back to blind try from Helena.
Pretty solid scores coming in for these ladies. That S1 from Lammert scored a 6.07. S1 from Helena.
A 7 around, huh?
Almost a 7. So big points for these ladies.
But actually, they're both riding out of our competition area down there.
Is that
as the buoy is
there is the buoy, yeah.
Let's see what our head judge Sammy Gully has to say to that. But that feels like the box is a bit shorter than the other days.
It does.
Maybe somebody didn't know where to put the buoy.
Well, it's really challenging because we've had the wind actually shift quite a bit yesterday.
Yeah, yeah.
And now it's almost onshore. These ladies are really...
Ooh, Helena trying, but really close to the beach. Ooh, and there is the front roll to wrapped NIS attempt from Lambert, and she pulled it off. So she's scoring pretty good, I think. Still waiting for approval of those tricks.
Yeah, a bunch of pretty solid tricks for her still to come in. Brashoka.
But I'm afraid she's in a very big lead there. Let's see what Helena can do, charging it. Oh, going for a back roll to Tosa. She wanted to go for that mope. She was talking about that a lot the last days, that she's getting closer and closer.
Oh, ooh. NIS. Did she get the bar or no?
Yeah, she grabbed the chicken loop on that. It was a 3-on-3, but yeah, she has the kite a bit too high to the left side, and that's always kind of pulling her arms too far away.
Well, I was thinking 3-on-3, and I said NIS. But it counts if they grab the chicken loop.
It counts, but yeah, but definitely less, huh? But Lambert's scoring good, so she's going to be a danger for the next girls as well, I guess.
Oh, yeah. She's definitely riding solid. I think she's probably got some fans back in the Netherlands watching her on the live stream, rooting for her. How are we doing on time?
Oh, we still got 40 seconds.
Well, there's still plenty of time.
Helena going for Rayleigh.
Definitely a lot of points still to be approved here. So, but I think it's safe
to say. Oh,
nice
back roll to wrap as well from Lambert. So yeah, I'm pretty sure as well. Give you that right. Ooh, another mope try, but she's kind of not popping out. She's just kind of going in the turn.
We've seen Lambert's a few other events. So at least I've recognized the name. I know we saw her last
year.
Yeah,
for sure, in Germany.
Yeah.
Events like that.
It's good to...
But it looks like she really improved.
Oh,
and
yeah. Definitely.
Making a run for her money.
Definitely a solid heat from Annelies Lambert.
Still waiting for some scores, but I think I can tell you that she won.
Pretty sure that she's going to be moving through that one, and she was going to come up next. She'll probably be meeting, let's see, who will she
the
be
winner
meeting?
Between Jungo and Try.
Oh, right.
From Estonia.
All right, so that's what we've got coming up next. We've got Manuela Jungo.
While Helena is taking a shortcut to the beach, like riding over the beach.
Those girls, those silly girls, they love doing that stuff. Actually, I saw someone basically do that all the way back to their hotel room last night.
As long as you don't hurt yourself, you know?
I'm not sure who it was, but it was pretty cool to see. Anyways, hope you guys are enjoying the action here from the Picare Panama, coming to you live from Nitro City on the shores of beautiful Punta Chame. I'm Dave Tiberski here with Michael Schitzhofer.
Hello, everybody.
And it's a banger day for sure. We've got solid wind, solid action on the water. Just going to go through probably just, let me just check my heat order right now.
We got one more girl
heat. One more
heat
women's
left.
Heat, and then we're going to switch gears back to the men's. So thanks for being with us. We've got a little over a minute until the start of that next heat. So rally the troops, let everyone know. Go straight to the YouTube page for or our YouTube channel at Pro PKR World Tour. To get the stream, as we're having issues getting it straight from our live page from the website. So that's the news. If you can pass it along, I appreciate it. So stick with us. We'll be back with more here live from Panama. We'll be right back. right, just a few more seconds into the start of the heat.
It's Manuela Junger from Switzerland against Triina Trei from Estonia. Blind judge from Manuela out there, going to the right, while Trina's coming in towards the left, going for Rayleigh out there. Saw some nice heats of Trina already, so let's see what those girls can show us. Whoever wins this heat has a hard one in the next heat, as Lammert really showed some incredible tricks out there in the previous heat. Manuela with a really direct, but couldn't land it. The kite was going too high. Pulled it out of her hands.
Triina from Estonia versus Manuela Junger from Switzerland. There's been actually a few good riders coming out of Switzerland, surprisingly enough, over the years. You wouldn't think so. But you wouldn't think from Austria we'd have ripping riders like yourself and
Stefan Spiesberg, a little country. Not too many places to kite at, but yeah. Motivated guys there, I tell you.
Yeah, you pretty much got to want it to get it. But we're coming back to Austria this year. How are you feeling
it
about
looks
that?
Like, yeah, it's great, great, great to have the PKRA back with a slalom event in Austria, in Podersdorf, at my home spot. It's going to be sick. Going to be there, going to watch it.
Are we doing kind of the, I don't know, best trick or anything?
Maybe
or
we do a little freestyle event there.
Are you going to
be
But
we have the PKRA in Leukatz just the week before, and it's ending on the first day, I think, of the slalom event in Podersdorf in Austria. So it's not going to be with the PKRA freestyle riders, but maybe we're going to pull a little freestyle competition for the Austrian guys there. But yeah, good to have the PKRA back, and maybe the next year we can do some more and get some freestyle going on at my home spot again.
Yeah.
It would be great.
That was always one of my favorite
mine
stops.
Too. Cheap journey.
Kiting out a kilometer into the middle of the lake to do your
tricky.
Heat.
But yeah, the part is always right there, huh?
Well, ooh, Manuela.
Crash from Manuela on a back to blind.
Two tricks landed for Manuela Jungo. Two tricks landed for Trina. Actually, basically one trick landed for Trina at the moment. Still waiting for scores to come in. Like we're trying to grab some audio for our live stream. What's up, Jeremy? You want to sit down and say hi to the people at home?
Just say sorry to the audience.
Okay. Recording in the camera. The man who makes all those awesome videos every night and every day and every event, Jeremy Lacoudy from Seventh Frame, apologizes for that. He was trying to steal some of the audio from this camera here. Actually, probably just trying to steal the image. Those dodgy Frenchmen.
Yeah, you never know what they're up to.
Man. All right, so on the water right now still is Manuel Jungo and Triina Trei. These ladies are going head to head. Pretty tight heat, but I think that blind judge
puts Manuela in a lead, huh?
Trina's got a pretty solid blind judge as well too, so it's kind of a wash, actually. That 313 from Manuela, that probably is going to inch her out in front, but it is still
not
anyone's.
By much, yeah.
Definitely an open open heat at this point.
Back roll to revert, back roll to toe side from Manuela Jungo there. I think she's holding a bit back, saving some energy for the next heat, but shouldn't be too sure about that. You never know. And then in the last minute, Trina pulls out a big trick and you are in a bad situation. Like this S-bend to blind from her right
now.
She goes. Ooh, that's going to score good. It looked very nice, very clean landing there.
She's
happy
claiming
it.
Yeah.
Yeah, but she got every right to do so.
That's right. It's got to feel good.
Scoring around 5.8 on this one, so...
It's not an easy place to be landing blind
no,
in this chop.
No, definitely. Close heats unfolding here. Also, I feel like I get burned in our booth here.
Yeah, the sauna factor is increasing rapidly here in the live stream booth. We do have two AC units cranking, but we're kind of behind a big glass in the greenhouse, in the glass room at the moment.
Yep, it's medium to well done for me already.
Just slather on some butter. That'll keep
another
you moist.
Another good tricks from the girls out there. But yeah, what an incredible setup out there, huh? In front of our booth with the kite action unfolding, nice beach, and the Nitro City location here where we are, where we have our tour stop. It's crazy, it's amazing.
It is. What an amazing venue for a PKRA event. I mean, I couldn't think of a better place to have one of these competitions, both for the riders and the staff and the spectators.
Yeah.
I mean, you basically... You could be lounging in the pool at the bar and still watching.
I think a few people
event.
Are doing that already, yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised. Maybe
it's
some of those
cool.
folks who've already been out,
yeah.
gotten out. But yeah, that's it. Red flag up. That's going to do it for our women for the time being. We're going to switch gears, head back over to the men's action, and we're coming up with Spiesberger and Jacobs. So...
Going to be a tough one.
Definitely a doozy coming up. You're not going to want to miss that. Stay with us. We'll be back here with more action from Panama.
Cooking. Alex going to surgery, yeah?
Really?
I think so, yeah. That's what you just posted. Hope we get better results here soon, huh? It's weird that it's like not a
yeah.
booking.
Yep, that is true. We were just commenting here as we were going into the start of this men's heat, Stefan Spiesberger versus Mark Jacobs.
And I asked already from Stefan Spiesberger, and I should greet everybody at home in Austria who is watching that right now on the live stream.
I'm sure.
He told me to do so. Maybe his family or friends are watching. Greets to everybody. Oh, nice KGB from Mark out
Willkommen.
There.
Willkommen.
Yeah, Servus nach Österreich.
Yes. The only other German I know is probably not appropriate for this live stream.
Maybe keep that for later, for the parties.
All right, so we've got on the water Austria versus
New Zealand. The Kiwi, who just pulled a very nice mope. Let's see what Stefan has to answer. Stefan feeling more and more confident here in the singles. He struggled a bit. Was a bit nervous, but yeah, now he's getting better and better. Nice grabbed Hinterberger mope. Also, I think the wind is better than in his first heat now. He's still on the 13, just like Mark Jacobs, also on the 13. But I think it's like the wind filled in better.
I think you're right.
Mark going for a front blind mope with the kite very low, just in front of the judging tower. That looked pretty insane. Okay, Stefan going for a mope here. Very nice. But I'm sure he wanted to do a mope 5 there, as he loves that trick. Going toe side, Stefan. Chrome mope with a butt check. Let's see what the judges will say about that.
We've got definitely a few points dripping in here, but man, some solid scores for Mark Jacobs.
Yeah, he had some very good tricks already. Yeah, with a very good cut position.
I don't have averages, but I'm seeing stuff in the mid sevens for two of his tricks.
Yeah, Mark always scoring really high. His style is like incredible. He's going so fast in and out of the tricks, except for this rally here. It's a pop. It's probably not what he wanted to do.
No, I don't think that would have been.
Stefan looks pretty powered already. Maybe his 13 is pulling too much already. Maybe he's a bit over, as the wind fills in really fast here every day so far. Mark going for a grabbed NIS. Landed very clean. Another toe side one from Stefan. Ooh, chrome up 5, but he had to let go of the bar. Unlucky, he landed on a wave there.
Ooh, brutal for Stefan, but man, he's I think he's pretty hungry, but he's gonna have to turn it on. We've got about how much time remaining in this one?
3 minutes and 40 seconds exactly. So. But yeah, also Mark Jacobs is pretty hungry, I think, after getting kicked out very early in our single elimination. He had to start in round one again in the doubles, and now he has landed this very nice Aspen 3 here. He's not giving it away for free.
No,
that's for sure.
No, definitely not. He's got plenty of time here for to make a comeback. He definitely needs a few good tricks here to kind of level the field. But Jacobs looks pretty powered. I think the wind's definitely building here.
Yeah.
Ooh,
grabbed back to blind. Yeah. Nice. But yeah, like when you see Mark riding like this, he's going so fast. It's very impressive. It's also impressing the judges to see him do stuff like that. And if he can land it in the chop, it looks very good. Going for a Tosa trick, Mark Jacobs.
Oh!
Chrome up 5.
Very
nice. And actually, this is the more difficult side here because he's left-handed. He's doing it to the left without a kicker. Most of our guys are right-handed, going to the right side, doing this toe side stuff with the kickers. So yeah, that was a very hard trick, and he's gonna score very good. Stefan aiming for our photographer, Toby Bromwich there.
Stefan needs to pull it out.
Ooh, lost balance on that mope 5. Unlucky.
What do you think he's got in his bag that he
I think he knows he needs to do his double back roll pass, double Hinterberger pass. He can do that pretty good. He has a very good trick in the pocket, a 3-on-7. I saw him pulling that off in the free ride a lot, but he's a bit insecure with that in the heats right now, he told me. He doesn't get the right pop in the moment. But yeah, there's no holding back in that far into the event. It's all or nothing. You have to risk to win.
Oh,
like,
man.
Just Mark Jacobs with a KGB to blind. Perfect. Just 1 meter before the beach.
Gonna be tough to beat right now, I'm telling you that much. Stefan's got some solid scores, actually, but definitely he's got a deficit. Still some time. He's going to need something big and see if he can do it.
Oh,
here.
There's the 3-on-7 attempt. Oh, but
going down.
Yeah, again, the pop wasn't perfect.
Right now, it's not. Well, there we go. He's got about a 7-8 point lead at the moment with Mark Jacobs. A really high scoring heat for Mark Jacobs. Already minus one of his tricks out that scored eights. He's got 35 points.
Stefan now having a bit of a problem with the kite on the beach. You're not allowed to help him there, otherwise you're disqualified, so he has to manage them himself. Yeah.
Is it actually being you're disqualified or you're stopped being scored from that point forward?
Yeah, that's a good question here now. I think you're stopped being judged.
I asked the tough questions.
Yeah, that's good.
I'm kind of like...
That's probably the guys at home also want to know. No, you're stopped scored, yeah. But you don't want that either.
All right.
Mark taking it easy already. In the last seconds, showing
going for that last
photographer grab.
Pop. Still waiting for that big KGB5 to come in. He's definitely got some
Stefan,
eight.
Ooh, now he wanted to go for the double Hinterberger pass. But yeah, it's also a mind game. If you know that you have struggled over the whole heat, it's also hard to pull the hard tricks in the last minute.
Wow.
So I'm afraid that's it for Stefan, and Mark will advance.
Too bad for Mr. Spiesberger, but... Mark
he had
Jacobs.
A very good heat against Mario already. So.
Yeah, he could definitely, probably is going to feel stoked with that heat and probably wish Mark well as he continues on up the ladder. It's always kind of nice to see the guy who beat you like go on and actually do some real damage. So
always easier to say, yeah, I lost against the winner, you know.
Exactly. So, but that's going to wrap up that one. We've got another men's heat coming up. We've got Posito Martinez from the Dominican Republic versus Reno Ramiro from Brazil. So Posito's been kind of ripping here.
Yeah,
kind of
he kicked me out yesterday. So
pretty. Yeah.
I hope he's going fast so I can say I lost against the winner.
Exactly. So that's what's coming up, folks. I'm losing pounds by the second here in the sauna. But hopefully you guys are feeling the intense heat that's coming from this action here in Punta Chame, Panama. Live from Nitro City, sitting here in Street Bike Tommy's. This is the
signature room
here in Nitro City. So, Street Bike, if you're watching, thanks, bro. We really are enjoying your digs, and wish you were here. So, anyways, there's more to come, folks. Dave Tarbersky and Mr. Michael Schitzhofer here from Panama. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
He's there.
Where is the cameraman? He's definitely... Looks like he's taking a break. There he is.
Martinez is charging already for his first trick here. Going big on a 315. Clean landing. Sick trick.
Very nice.
Also Reyno going full speed from the left to the right. Sick KGB from Reyno, but also Martinez pulled the trick, but I couldn't tell what it was. I didn't see it. So it's difficult if both guys pull the trick at the same time.
That happens actually fairly frequently. You can get an idea for how difficult it is for these judges to keep their finger on everything, but that is why there's five of them. There's a panel of five judges that we've got during every heat.
We also got even two riders sitting out there as a kind of trick spotters telling the tricks. NIS5 from Reyno down there. He landed clean, rode away, but now he had to let go of the bar as he was facing the beach. Now he's sitting on the beach. Martinez.
Wow, that was a back move.
Yeah, but the classic one.
Man, he has just got a really unique style. He's just like a few degrees of different axes on some of his tricks that just really makes it unique and interesting to watch.
Oh, so now there's a guy in the way of Reyno on the outside there. He's not going to like that. Just like in his previous heat where there was a guy in his water.
I can't believe this beginner is just still out, nothing against beginners, but like a nice back mob from Posito on this tack going out.
Reyno going for a mob. Nice. So, close heat so far, I'd say.
Definitely fairly tight for both of these riders. Posito Martinez from the Dominican Republic and Reyno Remy from Brazil.
Ooh, and NIS5 with a back check, actually.
Not a butt check, a back check. Seemed to just bounce.
But as far as I know, you have to land on your board first to even get the butt check. Back first doesn't count. Martinez, Aspen 3. Sick move. Reyno going for NIS.
Definitely a tight heat. Too early to call.
Still 4 minutes left.
Some tricks are... most of the tricks are in, but it's... Reno's got six trick attempts. And
just
he basically
seventh.
Has the same score as Posito does. Or I'm sorry, no, it's the other way around. Reyno has four trick attempts. And... Posito has six.
Reyno just pulled a very nice Aspen 3 with a butt check though. Let's see how much he can score. And Martinez charging it for a slim chance. But that was kind of low. So shouldn't score too high. Needs to pull off some harder tricks to win. Reyno going for a mob again. He's always trying to get his normal mob in and then going for a mob 5 to better his score. Did it in every heat so far. Couldn't pull it off on that one. Ooh, Reyno wanted to go for that front mob, I think, but now his kite kind of tangled. Oh, he was lucky on that one. Lines didn't tangle. Easily relaunch his kite.
Ooh,
sick Hinterberger pass from Martinez.
He
scored like a 7 in the previous heat with that.
Yeah, it's almost like he kite dove down as he took off. But
yeah.
Really low kite position, really well executed. That's
good score
high. Good, as the sun is starting to set, folks, it's 3:57 here in Panama. We've got on the water Reyno Remy and Posito Martinez from the DR. That is Reno right there on that kite with a V coming towards us.
Was going for the Tinterberger pass, but couldn't pull it. Still 1 minute 40 left on the watch.
Oh, Cito going down, missing the bar.
That KGB attempt, yeah.
How are we doing on time, Michael?
1 minute 18 left, so still enough time for both of the riders to throw in some tricks. Hinterberger mope from Reno out there, going to the left. Now he's kind of blocking Martinez. Reno going for that front mope now. Now he lands it nicely. Good kite position, good rotation down there. KGB from Martinez, kite almost in the water. Very nice trick. Good kite control from the Dominican guy. Seconds left. Let's see what the guys can show off in the their last tricks. Oh, Reno, another try for the Mope 5.
So coming up after this heat 42, we're going to switch over to the ladies and watch, I think, that heat with Lammerts.
Toe side taker from Martinez, but yeah, that wasn't any trick. It was just
and
a pop. 2 seconds left, so that's it for that heat. Yeah, and there goes the buzzer.
That's going to do it for those guys.
It was a very close heat, I think. Let's see if the last trick's coming in. Who actually made it? I think it should be...
Ooh, really tight heat.
Should be Martinez, though, with 0. Whoa.
Yeah,
point six.
By 0.6. Of a point, both scoring 30 points, 30.7
Tally
for
that.
Felix or Martinez, and 30.1 for Reno. So
Reno's not gonna like that.
Man, these heats just come down to the wire. It's
yeah.
pretty impressive to to see how tight some of these heats are. So
close heats always hurt more.
Oh, I can
kind of think, I would have added a grab there, a little tweak there. Maybe that would have changed everything.
And it can and does. And that's really what it's coming down to a lot of heats right now. Is
definitely, yeah. It's the little thing, the difference.
Exactly. Little overview shot here of the grounds at Nitro City. You can see the pool in the background. And pretty spectacular spot here. If you haven't yet been here, you definitely need to get down here at some point, because it's a great place to have a kite holiday or just any kind of holiday, really. You can pretty much do anything you want. Did you go to the party last night, Michael?
No, I didn't. Where was the party?
I guess it was at the cable.
Ah, yeah, it was like a night cable session, yeah.
I have to say
I missed it. I did a lot of kiting. I've been up at 6:30. Was on the water a lot in the sun. I fell asleep at 9 p.m. Not too brave, huh?
So I think Trina Trey advanced in that last one over Manuela Yungo.
Ooh, crazy.
So
the girl from Estonia. But she pulled, like I said, Manuela was kind of taking it easy. And in the end, Trina pulled that S-band pass and scored pretty good on that one.
Yeah, that's what it's showing here on the judging interface here, where our scores come in. We've got the yellow flag up and a little bit of time left before we get underway. But I just want to say thanks for being with us, guys. You can see here the sun is starting to dip here as we go through the changes of lighting here in our studio.
As we're getting boiled as well.
Exactly, we're pretty much frying. You can see, boom. Yeah, I'm gonna have to put some sunscreen on. I'm frying.
Maybe bring a cap, huh?
I know, but you're actually in the baking seat
right there.
You can see he's glowing right there. So I got pulling rank here. I'm sitting in, you know, more of the shade.
Okay,
area.
Give me 5 minutes and then we change spots, huh? You get the bronze.
You gotta beat me at something to.
Okay, the heat
deserve
is
that.
On. It's just started.
All right, we've got these guys on the water, Lammert and Trey.
Both on the same kites, slingshots out there.
Yeah.
Both started it easy with Rayleighs, I think. Nice S-band from Trina.
That Trey? Or was
no, that was a Lammert with a rail to wrapped. There with a blind judge.
That
clean
was
landing.
Lammert again. Was it?
Yep, yep.
Impressive riding. I think she's going to be... Woo. I mean, if she's got the right heat, she could take down, I think she would come up next to maybe...
I think it's Annabelle already. Our birthday kid today.
It's
her 20th birthday.
Oh my goodness, already 20.
Yeah, she can make herself a present
today. They grow up so fast, Michael. I tell you.
Back roll to wrapped attempt, but kite was a bit too high.
Doesn't make it easy when the kite's high.
It pulls so much.
Yeah, pulls so much, and that's a good way to dislocate your shoulder as well.
Yeah.
Speaking of dislocated shoulders, you had some news from Alex.
Yeah, Alex Pastor, our current world champion, just had an update on his Facebook saying that he was at a doctor, seeing a doctor at home in Spain, and it looks like he's going for surgery within the next week, as his labrum is broken and his shoulder was out. So yeah, he's taking the surgery, I think, and it's going to be out for a few months, but hopefully a fast and speedy recovery.
Yeah, it's amazing, right? You know, just with the technology these days, you can actually rehab certain injuries back. But who knows?
We had our former world champion, Yuri Soon, having the same problem last year in St. Peter Ording, and looks like he's going to be back in Maroc, in Dakhla, at our next competition. So good to have him back then.
That is going to be a doozy. I was just actually shopping tickets before we began the heats today. So if you guys want to come to a pretty epic spot as well, that place is solid.
Definitely. Some flat water, some waves, everything there.
Lammert continues her onslaught of freestyle maneuvers here.
She's going crazy out there, yeah?
Yeah, she's got some impressive bag of tricks and really good kind of, what is the word I'm looking for? Just consistency. She's just
And she's also like pulled out most of her tricks already within like, I think, 3 minutes. So, yeah, she's not waiting for the last minute. Trying to secure her win already in the beginning.
There's that beginner.
Yeah, again, huh?
Walking up.
Going up to make it another run through our area.
He's like, I'm going to take another heat. Hopefully he waits a little bit.
Yeah. Also, he has to take care of walking that close to our area with the kites up, that there is no tangling. Pretty sure he doesn't know the risk he's taking out there.
Little
nice back roll to toe side from Lammert. Trina edging, taking off for an S-bend to blind. Ooh, but crashes it. And
right now we got 16, almost 17 points for Lammert and 6 points for Trina. Yeah, we've got our. I actually went to Lammert's webpage. I forgot I think Dutch. Champion or something. I don't know. I saw some credentials from some other Dutch competitions. So,
yeah, for sure. She was at the European Freestyle Tour as well last year and the European Kite Tour. So, yeah. She got some experience in competitions. Maybe we see her more often this season on the PKRA. Yeah, definitely got the tricks, and now with a back roll to wrapped here, she's going to score good and She's in the lead here. Trina has to pull out some really good tricks to change that. While there's another beginner walking very close to our area. And I think he's almost facing Trina's kite there.
Pretty ideal spot to learn to kite here in Punta Chame, I'd say.
Definitely, but maybe not in the heat area.
No, probably not during a World Cup comp.
It's a bit easier in the beginning.
Ooh.
Now Lemon's coming down. She got really good tricks in her back tricks. She's kind of sending them. But so far so good. She's winning on this one, I think. As Trina struggles again and smacks the kite down. Her big lead while Trina is swimming with her kite on the beach, so that doesn't look too good for her right now, unfortunately. But I'm afraid even on a very good day, it would have been hard to beat Lammerts in this heat.
So coming up, we are going to switch gears over to our men's heats with Mark Jacobs versus Martinez, if that's what you're here to see. If not, we've got the men coming up your way with Mark Jacobs and Felix Antonio Martinez from the DR, also known as Posito. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with more from Panama. We're on. Mark Jacobs versus Posito Martinez, Dominican Republic, for Martinez and Jacobs from New Zealand.
Jacobs starting the heat with a nice KGB there. Martinez with a 315 with a butt check though. Both guys are going full speed into the trick, that makes it that much harder to land them. Score really good if you land them clean, but yeah, also bit more likely to get a butt check. Front blind from Martinez and a back mo from Mark Jacobs out there.
Jacobs seems to have enough juice in this heat as well.
Definitely.
It's an interesting matchup of styles.
Yeah, yeah. With the sick front blind, but with the kite very low from Mark Jacobs just now. Yeah, Martinez showed some very interesting tricks, like this Moab again.
Oh my. I mean, he landed with a board underneath him right there.
Yeah, he just couldn't hold the pressure, I think. Yeah.
That was some serious
And there, the switch Moab with the kite almost in the water.
Oh,
it's crazy.
Jacobs. Was that a Hinderberger?
I think it was, yes. Yes, full power. Just while Martinez was pulling another move.
Going downwind a million miles an hour.
Yeah, it's crazy how the speed.
No, definitely not holding back at all. Both these guys
Ooh,
charging.
Chromo 5 from Mark.
If I had to say right now, I think Mark has probably a one-trick advantage.
I think Mark scored really good on that last Chromo 5. Now he scored really high on those. So that's going to put him in the lead, I think.
He's definitely riding like our judges like to see. Kite low, coming in hot, landing with a lot of speed.
But actually, only two judges so far saw that Chromo 5, so let's see. Hinterberger move for Martinez. Kite super low. He loves the trick, I think. He makes it look very easy and clean. They're both charging again.
Whoa.
Double Aspen 3 from Mark,
wow.
And I think it was a KGB from Martinez. So hard to tell if the guys do it at the same time.
Mark was just rotating.
Spin to win.
Super fast. Landing. I love it when he lands and you just basically knees bend and your arms slap the water. You're just going coming down with so much power.
You just see when those 90 kilos come down on the water.
Yeah.
It looks different than the little kids doing it.
You might have feel that in Asia in a few days. That landing that Mark Jacobs just did might cause a small tsunami, displacing so much water on his landing.
With a mope with the kite on the beach.
And he basically took off, you know, like 10 feet from dry sand, not sure.
KGB to blind from Mark, ooh, but crashed it. It was actually a perfect landing, but with the waves there, he couldn't hold the balance.
Yeah, the tide is pushing in here, ladies and gentlemen. It's gonna be creeping up throughout the day, bringing the action closer to our camera. As we are here, it's about 4:18 local time. The sun is starting to dip. Martinez loading up.
Double Hinterberger. Pass attempt, but no, couldn't even go for the pass. It's all in your head. If you do the tricks too close to your beach during the air, you already notice it and you can forget the trick most of the times. Mark giving it another try for that KGB to blind, but didn't pull it. Half a minute left in this heat.
Half a minute, 30
half
seconds?
Half a minute, yeah.
Whoa. Not a whole lot of time.
I think one final trick of both of our riders out there.
Probably exactly at the same time. No.
Slim 5 for Mark. And a grab.
One-handed NIS?
One-handed NIS from Martinez. But actually not a clean landing.
Wow, it's going to be a tight heat. I'm going to have to give you my prediction. I'm thinking Jacobs is going to be taking that one.
Yeah, I think so too, actually.
Home and moving on to the next round. But we'll have to wait for the official results as we still have some time.
Yeah.
But that's going to do it for our men's right now. We're going to switch gears, get Miss Helena Beats back on the mic to help commentate our next women's heat. Let's see, who do we have? It's Annalise and Annabelle. So this is going to be a doozy. This I don't know. If I think if Anna Luce is on her game, she's going to be giving her Annabelle a run for her money. But is this me spitting on my computer, or is this something wet on here? Let's see what's going on. I don't know if I'm ready for your audio to be on yet.
All right, here I am.
But so we are basically standing in the booth.
Yes.
Because
there's a Sony banner that is obstructing our view over there. I'm advertising Sony right now.
But
great brand.
Yes, Sony is one of the sponsors of this event here, and there's actually, I think they've just like got helmets with their new GoPro competitor model camera, and they're just putting them on helmets, and people are just walking around wearing them. And Helena is grooving to the beats.
Yeah, I'm in a really good mood actually.
Why they call her Helena Beats? So how was your heat? Who'd you go down to?
I was with Anna Luce, and she crushed me. She scored like 30 points, which is like I think a second best women's score after that Carlina's heat with KGB and Backmo. Absolutely killed it. Super deserved.
Yeah, she was.
I'm pretty
riding.
Happy though. Like I mean.
Yeah, as long as you're happy with.
I'm always happy. Though,
Well, that's good. We like happy people here at the PKRA, and we like to see awesome kiteboarding as well, and we've been witnessing it throughout the day.
And I think this next heat is going to be really interesting because Anna Luce is full on her game today, and of course Annabelle would like to sustain her position from last season, so we'll see where it's going. I think that one is going to be really interesting because they represent pretty similar level, so yeah, we'll see what's going to happen.
That was my call, but I don't know, you know, what's you know, if that's good to say if they're at the same level, because with the women you've got a fair disparity of level. I mean, with the men as well, you know, you've got some heats where there's
I think
who's
men is like way closer. Like there's a big group of guys just like ripping it, and like there's so many of them, like basically anyone from top 12 can win an event, you never know. And with girls it's actually like a little bit more like distributed, let's say.
Yeah, there's
like there's like the absolute top three, and then like next top four, and then the rest basically.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's always different, but you never know what can happen when kite flies away, or you know.
True, and
the heat is on, I think.
Oh, they've got the double flag situation happening right there, which is never good.
But it's definitely on right now, and I see Annabelle coming out, and she's going with a blind judge, pretty big one. It's gonna be a nice score for that one, and Anna Luce following her. And with the blind judge, but way smaller, but also landed pretty clean, so. For sure, after that first trick, Annabelle's gonna be on the lead. But a lot can happen, we have 7 minutes.
A lot can happen in 6 minutes and 40 seconds.
I wonder what's it gonna be. And Anna Luce, she was trying to go for a 3-on-3, but she didn't pop right. And Annabelle right behind her with 3-on-3. They have exactly the same tricks. They're like following each other, doing the same things.
I think they almost have about the same bag of tricks.
Yeah, pretty much, I think.
Looks like Anna Luce. How do you pronounce her first name?
Has been too blind. She's got it. Anna Luce.
Anna Luce.
Oh, the kite check, but she's got it, so it's going to be scored. Right? Anna Luce, yeah.
Anna Luce is on a 10, and I wouldn't be surprised if Annabelle.
And Annabelle also has been passed.
I think Annabelle's.
Yes, Annabelle's for sure leading right better. Now. They have exactly the same move, although Annabelle's just doing everything a little bit bigger. So I'm pretty sure she's on the lead right now. The score should be coming up anytime.
Annabelle's gotten a pretty high level of consistency in the past year, really, since last year this time.
And it's a first full season, I think, from Anna Luce right now. So
is she going to do the whole tour?
I think that's her plan, yeah.
Oh, cool.
I think she can push the top three for sure. And 3-on-3 from Anna Luce, pretty well, nice one. Just really close to the beach, so now she has to get some. And Annabelle,
NIS.
I haven't seen. Was it an NIS?
I think so. Or
what that was.
Like,
just looking at Anna Luce, but something happened. Okay.
Her kite
Anna Luce
was
on the way
really
out.
Really high.
Back to blinds. Very nice one from Anna Luce.
Very nice.
Pretty big one.
Quite nice and low.
So now we're waiting for back to blind from Annabelle.
Should be
since
coming
I think
up
they're
here.
Doing like synchronized kiting over here.
It's a new discipline. Right now.
How cool would that be? Although everyone would like tangle
not
probably.
Not cool at all.
And Annabelle with back to blinds. Did I just say that? They're just following each other. That's pretty sick to watch. Should be similar score for back to minds. They're both pretty
13.78 right now for Annaluz.
Nice. It was like a sort of a Hinderberger from Annaluz. Like back to wrapped, but you know, weird one. Like pretty cool.
The weird one.
So yeah, it's gonna be
the weirder the cooler.
Like for guys, I don't know how they will count it, but for girls, it's gonna be counting like Hinderberger mope. And another blind judge for Annaluz, but bigger one and better one. And I think another NIS from Annabelle, but I was...
That one was better than her first.
So
sure.
Yeah, the first one was a little bit about checked down with the kite pretty high, so she corrected it. They're going like really close.
Yeah, these girls are really kind of getting after
a lot of
tricks.
Annaluz is 3 points behind right now, less than 3 points behind. So like, still a lot can happen. The
still
green flag
two
is
tricks
still
out, two tricks out for Annabelle and three tricks out for Annaluz, so it's...
And
tough to say.
Coming in, Annabelle on the way out. And Annaluz coming with a NIS as well. Oh, that was a pretty good one. And Annabelle blunders three.
Very nice.
Pretty good one as well. So I think still Annabelle on a slight lead right now. But Annaluz is catching up. She's going to do a trick right for Toby. There we go. Has been passed for Toby Bromwich. Very nice one, actually.
Very nice.
I thought she already did one, though.
She
Maybe
did.
She's just correcting
I
it.
I think she's yeah. just trying to get a better one. I think both of these ladies are going to top out on the tricks that they have on lockdown.
I think the scores are not updated. Like right now, Annaluz is showing up on a 10-point lead, so I think updated or something
is going
on. If it says
approve right here, that
no,
means...
No, I'm working on this.
I know, but these ones that say approve still,
yeah,
those aren't in the tally.
Yeah, okay. So the system is super complicated. I'm not good with systems.
Computers.
With computers. No, I'm sure.
Yeah,
right.
You're pretty good. You're pretty good on Facebook.
That's
and
my passion. My passion.
As it should be.
And Annaluz with one more 3-on-3, but unfortunately she missed the bar. And Annabelle, I cannot see. Ah, there she is. She's coming out from the right, from the outside of the box. And Annaluz is trying to get some height. And Annabelle with Rayleigh, and she crashes. And Annaluz with a back row. I think the wind is probably picking up, so it's getting a little bit gusty.
Pretty solid wind. I think this is a better wind than we had yesterday.
Yeah, for sure. It's stronger. And
so both these girls on, I think Annabelle's on a 9, and Annaluz is on a 10.
No, I think Annaluz is still, yeah, on a 10. I was on 11 out there as
oh,
well.
Oh, you were?
Yeah, it was pretty good on 11, actually. I would not take a 9.
Maybe I'm just seeing a logo or something on.
No, she's on a 10 definitely. And no, Annabelle, I think she was on a 9 because okay. She was complaining she was a bit overpowered on it.
Ooh.
Well, a different type of kite.
Oh,
so
going for a 3-1-3.
Oh, I see Annabelle down.
Missing
and
the bar.
And Annaluz with another Hinderberger mope, but pretty good one as well. And she's got it.
Kite went straight overhead though.
I don't
that
know.
Was pretty much a.
I don't know if how they're going to count it.
I think
the
they'll just score it
there.
Low. They'll just
yeah, might score low or might score as a crash as well. And now we have Annaluz
wow,
on the lead, and
these ladies
is a
are
wrap,
gonna,
so
they're going to max
oh, no,
out
yet.
On their trick attempts. Already Annaluz is on her trick
they're
attempt
really
11,
close.
So she's got one more.
Yeah.
And that is, ooh, and she's
and
done.
Annabelle on the way out, and there's going to be trick for Toby Bromwich. Has been passed,
oh,
crashed.
Man, this is a banger heat for these ladies here.
That's a really interesting heat, actually. They're like going head in head.
Yeah, Lammert is done. Yeah. Anything she does now is not going to count. She's done with
is
her
it
trick
12 attempts.
Yeah.
No, she's got one more right here.
No, that's Annabelle.
Oh, that's Annabelle. So, yeah, Annaluz used all her tries. I think she knows it because she seems to be coming back to the beach. And Annabelle has one more attempt left, which might change
wow.
the... But the flag is down, and Annabelle with Rayleigh.
And that's going to do it, regardless.
I think that's going to do it, unless she's going to do something on the sand, pretty much.
They can still do tricks. They're just not going to count.
Yeah,
both of these ladies have their 12 trick attempts. And how many of them are counted? The
and
same as the guys, right?
I know there's a slick back to blind crash, though. Yeah, but nothing is going to count. I don't think they were counting. Sorry?
No, the for the women, it's the 5 tricks.
Oh, yeah,
same
5 tricks
guys.
Count. Same for the guys. We have 12 attempts and 5 best trick counts.
Right, so that's going to do it
that's
for that women's heat. That's a lot
looks
of
looks like it's
gonna
stuff be going to be Annaluz.
And I think Annaluz
on the lead
is going to take home the bacon.
So that's a pretty good start of the season for the new girl.
Yeah, definitely. That would be
sick. I'm pretty
considered
happy
an upset if there ever was a definition of an upset.
Yep, and they're out. Well, definitely well-deserved when, like, she's been ripping today.
Oh, yeah.
Like, always didn't give me any chance.
Well,
in my heat.
As I was talking with Michael, you've got a... You always got to hope that the person who takes you out is the one who takes the gold. So,
well, they're both killing it there. So that was really close heat. Oh, so we're going to the guys now.
We're going to the guys. So
I'm going to leave you with Shitzy, who knows what are the spins to wins. And right. Dave, of course.
All right. Well, thanks for being with us, Helena.
Thank you. And I'll be back for, I think, next women's heat.
All right.
If anyone is still not bored with my talking. But
well, you're not. That's what's important.
I can go on for ages.
Okay.
All right. See you later.
That is true. Helena Beats right there, one of our female competitors, helping out with the commentary for the ladies. And that was a sick, sick heat. I'm going to have to reiterate that. That's awesome to see those ladies going so hard, getting after it as they were there with Lammerts and Annabelle Van Mestrop. But Lammerts going through, taking the bacon home, so a bit of an upset for the young Ruben rider, Annabelle Van Mestrop. But there's more men's action coming up. Right now we're going on to what? I think that is men's 43. No, we already had that, so now it's men's 44. So we've got man, former five-time world champion Aaron Hadlow, going up against Mark Jacobs. Mark is going to definitely be a tired puppy after this one. Can he maintain?
On rolling.
Yeah.
Keep his flow going. I think we're going to see the first trick from Aaron in this heat, as he's charging already, unhooking, Mope 5, ooh, that was clean and fast, perfect kite position, that's a good opener. Let's see what Mark has to say as an answer. KGB also with a good kite position there. Aaron wasn't too satisfied with his heats yesterday. Oh, sick front blind mope from Aaron. Yeah, maybe he got a bit more aggression due to that he's not that happy from yesterday.
Oh, Jacobs big going monster.
Pass.
Well, I think I have to turn down the music so we got some audio for our video crew to use unobstructed.
So yeah, Aaron losing against Hilario Robinson from the Dominican Republic yesterday in the fight for the third place. I'm sure he wants to make that spot today at least, or go even further. And yeah, with that NIS5, he's going to put him in a good position. Mark Jacobs has quite some heats on his back already. The fatigue is pretty high in heats like that where you have to push so much. There are no easy heats.
No, there are not. That is very true. These guys.
Front blind. Ooh, Mark. Maybe there you can see it already a little bit. Huh?
Little tired. And Aaron. Ooh,
double S3. Man. Very nice. So clean.
Kite coming down and landing really fast.
Yeah. That will score pretty high. Also, he should be in the lead with the tricks. He did more tricks already, and I think he's going to score higher as well.
Yeah, already 22 points on the board for, or actually that's out of three tricks for Aaron Hadlow.
Crazy.
That fourth one still to come in.
Every trick above the 7 points, so that's pretty good if you can keep going with that.
I think Aaron's been kind of just waiting and watching today, relaxing. Definitely hasn't had to expend much energy. Ooh,
oh, another
Mark.
Front blind mope crash. Hey. And that's costing even more energy, and it's more exhausting when you crash, and he's going to feel that. Aaron going toe-side, but didn't see the spot there. Turned back. Now again. Tootsie Roll there. It's a NIS, but you take off from toe side.
Aaron's got some nice toe side tricks as
well.
Yeah,
he definitely got them.
It's really nice to see when those are thrown into the mix.
And he makes him look very stylish and very easy. It's always important to impress the judges.
Do you have any toe side tricks?
Yeah, some. Like the chromo.
Oh,
another
Mark.
Crash.
Oh.
And hitting a camera guy down
almost
there.
Almost taking out the cameraman.
I think that was Hendrik Berger.
Oh.
And another rider.
Trick from Aaron out the down at the bottom of the box. I'm not sure what it was. I think he took off from toe side as well.
But it's like only half time in this heat, and Aaron with a big lead, having five tricks on the scoreboard already. Almost 35 points scored.
It's definitely anyone's competition at this point with so many heavy hitters still out there. Aaron clearly hungry. Jacobs as well. But, then our top three other riders still have to go.
There. SPN 3 from Mark Jacobs here. Powerful, fast, clean. It's also what the judges are really looking for. Aaron charging it again. NIS 5, but that's a crash. Even though he kind of ride away in the end, he was too long in the water.
Not what he wanted, that's for sure. I think Mark has got some room here if he puts together a few big tricks.
KGB from Arona. That was close to crashing.
That was just getting that edge of the board around.
Yeah, the 180 was almost too late. But he landed it. Another front blind move from Mark. And this time he landed it.
Definitely going to be down to the wire here if Mark Jacobs keeps putting together some of these big tricks.
Almost 2 minutes left still, so Aaron can't be that safe, so I'm not sure.
Ooh, grabbed NIS.
Good one.
Adding all these little details to your trick really can make the difference.
Yeah, we have so many blind shot try from Aaron. He's giving Mark a hard time out there. But as you say, these little details, we have so many heats that are won by like 0.1, 0.2, and then a little grab can change everything, can put a heat in your favor.
And I think these guys know it too, and those guys are, that's kind of what a lot of the training focus is now.
Chrome up 5 from Mark there, from Mark Jacobs, our Kiwi. So that heat is far from being over, I tell you. It's in the last minute. But Mark is still scoring high. But he needs one more really good trick to change something.
Definitely getting down to the wire at this point. Less than a minute remaining here with Aaron Hadlow coming in for what could be one of his last tricks.
NS5, but I'm pretty sure he wants to go for the Slim 7 or NS7. But if you don't get the right takeoff, it's very hard. With 15 seconds left, let's see what Mark can do. KGB blind attempt for sure.
Catching that heel side edge.
Really bad crash.
Just going down.
But yeah, he knew he had to try something like that.
Whiplash territory, but Mark Jacobs giving it his all here after he's already moved through how many heats today? Fourth heat. Okay.
So yeah, that's tough in the end, huh?
Yeah.
It takes so much energy.
Definitely exhausting for those guys. Let's see if these scores start to get approved here on the system. But right now we're seeing
Aaron in the lead.
Yeah, I think it's going to be a 36 points win for Aaron Hadlow to 34 points for Mark Jacobs.
Very high score, and the heat was very, very clean and good from Aaron.
Some highlights from that heat from Mark Jacobs was probably that S3 scoring a 7.23 from Aaron Hadlow. Front Brian Moeb scoring 7.73.
Also really Miss Blanchard 5 with 7.6 score.
Big tricks going down here in the Nitro City. This is the place to be, you guys. I'm glad you're here with us. I'm Dave Tyberski joined by Michael Schitzhofer. We've got double elimination action going on right now. Riders, male riders, pretty much on their 13s still, I think, and 12s maybe. And some of the female riders on 10s. And onshore conditions, as you can see, tide is filling in at 4:40 local time. Wind should still be increasing, and we are heading into the wee hours of our double elimination. Coming up next is Women's Heat 20. Can I pull this together? I haven't filled out my ladder.
I think it's Lammerts against
Pulido. Yeah, exactly. So that's what's coming up. I'm not sure if Helene is going to make it in time for this one. But
maybe she's celebrating with Lammerts down there. She was very happy, very enthusiastic about the win of Lammerts.
It's always good to be enthusiastic about the person who beat you winning. But that's coming up. So you're in the right place. Less than a minute remaining here in Nitro City, Panama. Don't go anywhere. And it looks like we are on with Gisela Pulido, our current world champion. Isn't that right?
She
took the title last year.
But only with a third place in the singles and a nice 3-on-3 on her first trick. But yeah, she's not happy with that third place.
No, definitely
that's for
not
sure.
At all.
Oh, nice blind shot from Lammerts already. She's on a winning streak there. She has a run.
She's definitely had a good run. Nice to see some new faces start to bump up towards the podium.
Especially in the girls' divisions. We had it in the last years, kind of same faces a lot. And
yeah.
It's good to see new ones.
Definitely.
There are so many good riding girls out there. They just have to take their heart in their hand, take the courage, and go for the PKR events.
Yeah, that's true. I mean, it's pretty impressive to, you know, you travel around the world and you see some girl ripping who could definitely be doing pretty well in some of these women's heats, and if they were just step it up, come on and see how they do against some of these other ladies.
Very
here
nice
on the tour.
NOS from Gisela. That was a really good trick. Let's see if Anneliese have anything to answer that, but some girls can't do those inverted tricks, so if you have those in your bag, it's pretty good for you. Wow, Gisela with a Blanche 3, I think. Very clean there. She's going into the tricks with a lot of speed, taking risk. That's what the judges love to see.
Ooh, Lammert.
Rail to wrap the tent.
That was just still too high.
Also, she got, like Mark Jacobs, a lot of heats already on her back, and maybe the fatigue is setting in already, huh?
Yeah, well, she's had quite a few heats herself. I'm sure she's feeling a little tired after.
Has been too blind, but she sticks that.
Getting,
controls the car.
Yeah, 12 trick attempts in her last, both that last heat, Annabelle and her maxed out their trick attempts.
Yeah, that's crazy, huh? Girls are ripping out there. Gisela charging for another one. Let's see. S-band, one. Ooh. Nice. Little butt check there, though. Lamertz didn't find the right spot to take off. She was unhooking and charging, but couldn't pull it.
Definitely, you can tell Lamertz is no stranger to competition. She's got a good strategy. She knows to stay right in front of the judges, looking for that nice flat water in the inside.
Ooh, back to blind. Clean landing there. Good trick for her. It's like halftime through this heat. I think Gisela should be in the lead. But there's still a lot of time for Lamertz to pull some tough tricks. She's going for one right now. How about again? Didn't find the takeoff.
Not getting what she was looking for.
Gisela, second time that she tries that Hinterberger pass, but kite was a bit too high again.
25 points right now for Gisela to 16 for Lamertz. So Gisela's got a pretty solid lead right now. 10 points, a little bit beyond halfway through this one.
Yeah, that NOS scored like 7.47 for her, and that's like a really high score for girls. Like, it was a really good trick. Now the back roll to wrap for Lamertz. It's going to help her a lot. But there's... she has to make up a bit more points. Gisela coming in hot. Oh, now she landed that Hinterberger mob really clean.
Really nice execution on that.
Oh, that's going to score so high as well.
Definitely, she's... definitely got some power into that trick. She had some nice ones yesterday as well.
Front blind mob attempt from Gisela, but really had a nice face plant there in the close to the beach. But yeah.
Crash for Ana Luz on
a
3-1-3 attempt.
So 2 minutes left in this heat. Gisela with a clear lead. Both girls looked really powered on their kites already. I think the wind is still increasing.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's kind of just going to build throughout the day. We've got not too many heats left to wrap up the double elimination. I think we've got, like 3 or 4 heats left.
Yeah. Depends on how the winter finals goes. But
yeah, that's true. If someone takes down Christoff Tack in the first heat, they're going to have to go again. True to the double elimination format for a super final. Definitely always exciting times to see a super final go down.
Yeah. Excitement pour. And it's the last minute for this heat, for the girls' heat. Let's see if they have like both one more sick trick in their pockets. Gisela going for a back to blind. Clean landing there. She's going to have a really good score in the end of the heat. As she pulled some very nice tricks. Lamertz charging for another one. Going for that NIS.
Yeah, Lamertz kite's just a little too high. She needs to try and get that work on that kite position.
Yeah, and Gisela was training in Sri Lanka over the winter and seems like she had some good training there. Her tricks look really powerful and good kite position. She goes very fast into the tricks, so I think she had a good time on the water in Sri Lanka. And there is the front blind again, but she crashed again. Oh, she wasn't happy about that, hitting the water.
That's going to do it for our ladies. We've got 26 points for Lamertz to 33 points at the moment for Gisela Pulido. So that's going to put Gisela Pulido moving on through as we are going to move on to our next men's heat. And we're going to take a quick break, get these ladders filled in, and be back with more men's action here, wrapping up the double elimination live from Panama. We'll be right back. All right, we are back here with Robinson Hilario versus Aaron Hadlow in the booth. I've got our friend Nico Suriel from the DR. What's up, Nico?
Hey, what's up, Dave?
We've got the action on the water. This is your buddy from the DR.
Paul
Cabarete is watching to see what happens with this heat with Robinson Hilario finishing third in the single elimination. Here he is meeting the fourth place finisher in the single elimination, Aaron Hadlow. So we've got both these riders on the water. Aaron Hadlow, obviously.
Oh, nice. Oh, he crashed on the front blind mode.
Mr. Five-time world champion, Robinson Hilario from the DR versus Aaron Hadlow from the UK. Aaron's got his kite back up.
Hilario coming in with some power.
He's looking pretty juiced. He's on an 11-meter kite. I think Aaron maybe
nice
as well.
Oh, nice blind mode from Hilario.
Definitely these boys need to start getting some points on the board. They're kind of in an interesting rotation, a little bit too close to each other almost. Sometimes you get into, ooh.
Big back move also from
nice.
Robinson. Robinson's having a good start so far.
He is. He's an impressive rider. It's good to see him finally coming back and getting some decent results.
Yeah, like he's been training a lot this winter, practicing a lot, just starting to get ready for the season.
He hasn't really been on tour for a couple years now, I think I saw on his Facebook page.
Yeah, he was, I don't know, there's some issues with him trying to get around, but I'm glad he's back on and we'll be traveling a lot together this year.
Awesome. NIS. From Aaron Hadlow at the top of the box. There's Robinson Hilario.
Nice KGB with some power.
Really nice power. Very good kite position. Aaron going for a front blind.
Front two blind there. Didn't really get it to the heel side. Robinson with the nice 315. A little butt check there, but pretty clean though.
As the sun is starting to give us a little backlighting here at 4:54 p.m. in Panama, we've got on the water our third and fourth place finishers from the single elimination. I know Robinson's pretty hungry. I talked to him yesterday, and he wants this one.
Oh, it was hilarious. After he got third place, he wasn't that surprised or even happy. He was like, oh, I'm going for the first.
He wants gold. That's just not even a taste. That's just like seeing it, getting the mouth watering.
Aaron with a back to blind. Robinson, double S3.
Ooh.
Ooh, nice.
Pretty much stomping it. I'm not sure if he went to a little butt check, but he definitely had his board underneath him.
Kite was pretty low, though.
Definitely a powerfully executed trick right there, double S3.
Oh, that's a Tootsie Roll.
Right now, pretty tight heat already. Robinson Hilario, 32 points. Aaron Hadlow, 25 points.
Go Robinson.
So Robinson Hilario is kind of tearing up the water at the moment. I'm sure all eyes of Cabarete are on the screen right now.
I bet.
Rooting for this young Dominican. Saludos a todos de Cabarete. As well as Aaron's fan club, I'm sure, is watching him. Support of the five-time world champion.
Aaron with a double S. Ooh, Hilario with a blanchage 5. Real clean.
Missed that one. As Hilario continues his... unleashing his arsenal. We've got...
oh, here goes with the big big double Hittenberger 3.
Both these guys are flying, covering a lot of distance on these tricks.
Yeah.
Definitely, I think these guys have pretty good power in their kites at the moment. Did you get out today? Nico? You been riding it all today, or just?
Nah, I've been hitting the cable though. I've been enjoying that a lot. Like this was my first time since I came here, like actually hitting the cable. Aaron with a big crash. I'm not sure if that's considered a land right there, or if so, it wouldn't be scored that much. Amundsen, one-handed front line, didn't quite land that one.
Definitely, it's tough to keep that kite when it's so low. It's tough on that trick to keep the kite from clipping the water, but when you do, it usually results in some pretty big points. Aaron's got a very solid front blind mob as well.
Yeah, Aaron's last heat was sick, though. So I thought it was going to be pretty difficult for Robinson so far, but it looks like Robinson's nailing everything down. Aaron crashing on a NIS-5.
The heat is still young. 34 points right now for Robinson.
Nice.
25 points. So Robinson definitely has a solid lead. It is fairly open at this point, though. Time-wise, if Aaron can put some big tricks down on the judges' tablets as well as maybe try and keep Robinson a little bit at bay. There's a lot of strategy that goes into these heats right now. These guys are, seems like Robinson likes to ride behind Aaron to see where he's going.
Aaron crashing on a blind. Robinson with both crashing on some doubles.
Missing the same trick, I think. Probably going to see a repeat of those two tricks here momentarily. Already 10 trick attempts. Trick attempts for Aaron Hadlow, and let's see, we've got Robinson's already done.
Oh damn!
So Robinson is expired his trick attempts already at 34.97. So Aaron has two trick attempts to make up a 7-point deficit, and it's not going to be in time enough. I don't think. I think we could have a. Another,
I think Robinson's got that one right
I think you might be right on that as I'm looking here, and every sign that I'm seeing is pointing to that fact, although there is a S-Mob 7 or Slim 7, that still has to come in from Aaron Hadlow, so that could be the deciding point or that deciding score in that. Let's see if it is going to make a difference or not. And it is not. It's not going to be enough. 28.22 for Aaron Hadlow, losing out to Robinson Hilario's 34.97.
Nice.
So congratulations to the young Dominican rider. And
glad to have Dominican on the podium now.
That's right. He's going to be pretty happy about that. Do you think he can continue the charge?
I think he
can make it
pretty
well.
And I think he's got a chance to get second and even first.
Is that right? Well, it's just going to have to wait and see. And in the meantime, we're going to switch over to some women's heats coming up. We've got Helena Beats on the mic, and we're going to see who's coming up. Do you know who's coming up, Helena? The ladies?
Gisella.
We've got Gisella and Bruna. All right. So no strangers to competition. Either of these ladies, they've been in heats countless times. They're going to be coming up next, so don't go anywhere.
good broadcasting.
All right. Yeah, I will let you know when we're live, Helena. So don't worry, you can say anything if you want right now.
Well, you're totally right, live right now.
Totally live
totally,
right now.
I knew it. I told him to let me know before so I don't say something stupid online. All right, so Bruna coming in with a 3-on-3, crushed.
Missing her first.
Oh, it's really bad to crash first heat trick. It just messes up your head a little bit. But hopefully she can get back in the game.
I am sure she can.
There she is. And Gisela coming out.
Bruna's a determined young woman.
Gisela with a Blunders 3. Really good one. Pretty big. And Bruna is coming back. Getting some speed. And that's going to be, again, trick for Toby Bromwich over there. Swimming around. Money shot. Oh, no. I don't think she got enough speed.
Bruna's going to take another whack at that last trick. She crashed, sure. I'm sure. Most of these riders pretty much have
same tricks.
Yeah, somewhat of a choreographed heat schedule that they...
I think pretty much everyone has.
Yeah,
like at least like three first tricks. And then you go, oh, and I went nice flat 3 from Bruna. And Gisela coming in. And Gisela with an NIS. And she goes down, unfortunately. I think that's going to be a crash.
I'm not sure.
I don't know. Might be big butt check, but I think
that's probably not. She's going to do it again, put it that way.
Sure,
she's going to try and improve on that one. That's what a lot of these riders do. If they do a trick that they know they can actually execute better, they will definitely repeat that trick trying
and
to
Gisela
up their score.
Going for Esben pass. Clean one.
Getting it.
And Bruna, I haven't seen, but she just landed something.
She was a blind judge.
Was it? All right. So she's back. So far, Gisela on a pretty strong lead, but it's still pretty early in the heat, so we'll see. And Bruna.
Oh,
damn,
3-on-3 attempt.
Another 3-on-3 attempt that is crashed, unfortunately.
She's got what it takes. She's gonna need to pull some tricks here. She's
definitely. I've seen her doing like the best Blunders 3 I've ever seen in Newcastle 2 years ago. I think it was, but everyone was like, "Whoa, that's big." But I don't know if you've seen that in Lasky, Gisela almost pulled front blind mope heelside, which I never seen any girl getting even close to that.
Oh,
and the Hinterberger mope for Gisela.
Gisela's Hinterberger mopes are really coming along.
They're good, eh?
Yeah, they're really nice.
But she's gonna for sure do it again.
I'd love to see her stick front blind mope heel side.
Yeah, she like almost hit it. I couldn't believe it. So I think she's gonna go for it again. Bruna. I would say as last trick.
Bruna not really getting it all together at the moment. Just going, I think for an S bend a blind and just.
Yeah, she should try something else, I guess.
Definitely gonna need to turn up the heat at this point. We're getting close to being halfway through it. The heat, if not already there, and we've got 7 points for Bruna Kajia and already 14. So Gisela doubling Bruna's score at the moment. There's still time, but it needs to start to be turning on about right now. And Gisela continues to kind of keep that deficit where it is.
And Bruna with a S bend to blind, but that wasn't really a big one.
Nope, not too big.
No.
But she's, you know, she's coming off
she
an ACL
injury. She seems to be a little bit underpowered,
injury.
Actually.
Yeah, she does look to be on, I think she's on her 9. And
maybe it's, the wind is really weird, as I said like a million times already probably, but it just goes up and down the whole time.
Gisela's on 11, if I'm not mistaken.
And no, no, I was just holding Gisela's 11. That's why I wasn't here for the previous ladies' heat.
So she's,
so she's on
a 9
and 11. Christine is holding it there on the right somewhere. But it was, I was pretty powered standing on the line with 11, so I would definitely be on the line right now.
And
she unfortunately landed just on this wave. I think if it was flat, she would have had it. So Gisela is down, and Bruna is, I cannot see her right now, so she's
back to blind
there
from Bruna. Not very big or powerful. She seems like she's riding really apprehensively. I mean, she's coming off her ACL injury, but we saw some pretty big riding from her in the single elimination. So I know she's got it in her. Maybe she's just not feeling it.
Well, that back to blind scored like 5.2. So that's not bad either.
but we know she can do better. That's
definitely, yeah, of course.
We've seen it before.
Well, it's normal. She's taking it slow.
Yeah, I mean, you know what? If she gets second in this event, she's...
That's already, like, yeah, after injury like this, so soon, that's a huge, great achievement. Yeah, they both seem a little bit under power right now. I think the wind is a little down. And Giselle on the way in. And Brun on the way out. I think Giselle is too close to the short to pull any trick right now. Yeah, she's going to try to the right side. And Bruna is getting some height there. So probably she's going to throw something big. And Gisela with another back to blinds. And again, that was going to be a crash. But she's in a pretty strong lead, so still nothing to fear.
She's definitely...
Well, not such a strong lead anymore, actually. Now it's just 3 points difference.
Oh, wow. She's...
Yeah, Bruna is catching up right there. So we'll see what
it's
happens.
Still on for this heat right now with
only
Bruna.
Only 1 minute left, though.
1 minute left. Yeah, the
spike
just
dropping. Right now, Bruna
dropping.
Has a chance to catch up.
So Brazil versus Spain on the water right now. Both these ladies going for it. This is for second and third place.
So I think this is like the final tricks, and these are going to decide who's going to...
It's going to have to be big from Bruna.
Yeah. Bruna did a rally.
Not funny. Not she so seems powered. To be favoring... Her port tack for some reason.
Yeah, I have no idea. Maybe it's the knee.
Yeah.
And Gisela with the... What?
Oh, both girls going down.
I don't know how it's going to be counted. Well, she didn't really go down. She's just standing on the sand. I wonder what's it going to be.
I'm not sure.
And the heat is pretty much a wrap.
And that's final seconds of this one winding down.
Both girls... Gisela on the shore and Bruna swimming. She's up, so maybe she can pull out the last trick. If she threw one more big one, she still could have taken that lead. And Gisela with the front
blind, missing it.
So that's going to be it. And that's going to be a heat for Gisela this time.
I think it's going to be a Gisela Pulido ousting Bruna from her second place finish in the single eliminations. Will she be able to continue that charge up the ladder to dethrone Karolina Wenkowska? You'll just have to stick around and wait and see as... We are going to be switching gears back to the men.
Yes.
And
so
coming up, we've got what? Robinson Hilario versus...
Neto, I believe.
Neto.
Yeah. So
all right. So
I'm
this is
giving the mic back to Nico, who's going to lead you through the spins to wins, because I have no idea what they're doing out there. So see you later, guys.
All right. Thanks, Elena. That's right. We've got back in the booth Mr. Nico Suriel, right there.
Hey,
Nico,
guys.
People want to see you at home. Oh. They're like, Mr. the man with
hey
the
guys,
golden
glow. Hey guys at Kite Club, how you guys doing?
That's right. We've got DR in the house, Dave Tyberski and Nico Suriel bringing you the action as we're in the just the final few heats of our double elimination.
Yeah.
We've got just, it could be three heats, it could be just two. So this is going to be the battle with Robinson Hilario versus Alex Neto, Brazilian and Dominican riders, both well represented here at our first tour stop of the year in Panama. Quite a big posse of both Brazilian and Dominican riders, with Alexander Neto finishing second in the single elimination.
Had a great heat against Hadlow.
And now meeting up against the young Dominican Robinson Hilario. So definitely some talent coming out of both of those countries, and it's going to be the battle right now.
Yeah.
So it is anyone's game. Let's going to queue up the scores here. We got just over a minute until the start, so don't go anywhere. We'll be back with Robinson Hilario and Alexander Neto. right. We've got just a minute until the start. Just under a minute, actually, until the start here. Green flag getting ready to go up.
And here's the start.
Ooh, with Robinson.
Coming in with a good speed. Good start. Big blind judge.
Nice blind judge.
Three.
Neto, both these guys are hungry.
Young and hungry.
Yeah, how old is Robinson now?
I'm pretty sure he's 20 or 19, around there.
I think that's kind of the question. I'm not sure if he knows how old he is. Oh! Kite just super low. What was that, an NIS?
Yeah, big one.
Big one with a kite just super low, landing hard. Couldn't even see him landing.
Neto, the big S3.
So what are we going to see from Neto for sure? We're going to see what, that double grab KGB probably?
And that Chromobe 5.
Chromobe 5.
And Robinson, I'm expecting him to do his one-handed double S3 and his double Hindenburg 5s. Nice front blind mode. Oh, kite so low there. That's going to definitely score really high.
Definitely powerful. Ending up a bit on the beach. It's kind of a... I think we got a little bit of a side short cant. He should be able to get off the beach a little bit.
I wonder what's going on.
I don't know.
He's having some technical difficulties right there. Neto, I didn't catch that trick over there, but wasn't too powered.
I think it was just a mob. Robinson trying to edge on the sand, get off the beach.
Trying to get back in the water.
There he goes. That's
Neto with a chromo 5.
Ooh,
that was
getting big. It. Little splashy at the end, but pretty solid kite position.
Sick and powered, yeah.
Very nice.
See Robinson with a NIS, nice power.
NIS 5 or?
No, just in a just plain NIS, but right. Really low in power, so it should still score pretty high.
Definitely have some tricks still out, but it's still young in this men's heat with Robinson Hilario from the Dominican Republic and Alexander Neto from Brazil. Neto coming in. Actually, that's Hilario right there in that blue kite coming towards the beach here, 5:15 local time. Sun's getting down on the horizon. Got about another hour of competition.
Neto with a slim 5. Nice. Robinson coming in. KGB, pretty well.
Stomping that.
I think there's a grab in there, too.
This is going to be a tight heat. Both these riders really
can't really tell who's
carrying
really
some
so
power.
Far.
No, definitely a tight matchup. Just looking at the scores of what is in, it looks
Robinson
like
right there.
Basically, these guys are a trick apart in scores. It's still anyone's game right now. Less than 2-3 points of difference between these two riders. So the heat begins now. Neto's been riding really consistently as well. It's an impressive.
Very well, actually. Like, I was training with him last year, like when we were doing the peak era, and he's definitely advanced a lot. Oh, Robinson, double S1 with one hand. Whoa. Kite low, powered, coming in fast to the beach again.
Almost taking out another spectator on the beach. Good thing that guy was quick on his feet. He might not have a head. But
the KGB
ooh,
from
there
Neto.
It is with a grab. Kite locked and loaded. Very nice.
Robinson double back. Ooh, double back. Double Hindenburg. Pass. Kite was kind of
like
high there,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, kite got a little high. I think he wanted the 5 out of it, too, but didn't really get it around the toe side.
That's been his signature trick in Cabarete so far.
So any upcoming Dominican riders that aren't here?
Not really. We actually got them all over here. We've got like tons.
How many Dominican riders came to this event?
Pretty sure it's 7 or 8.
Jeez.
We got one girl and I think 7 guys.
Oh, that's right. Katie's here.
Yeah.
That is Neto.
Slim.
Oh, ooh, going for the seven. Missing it. Didn't grab the bars, right? Robinson. Oh, just a blind judge. I think he was going for a five there, but...
Whoa, really?
Oh, he got caught on someone, I think. Having some problems with his kite.
Really nice style from there both of go. These riders.
Very.
Robinson's both. Got a really fluid style. He
all toe-sided come in, Robinson. Just a back roll, didn't quite get what he wanted. Robinson with just a 3-1-3 on the outside.
It's getting down to the wire. We've got already 11 trick attempts for Robinson Hilario.
That was a nice Pete Rose from Neto over there.
Robinson has got one more trick attempt.
Roll, shoot.
Neto
really?
Has got four more. So it is down to the wire.
Robinson better make this last trick his best one. Let's see.
Oh! Ooh,
S3 kite right on the water. I mean,
very... Very nicely executed. That's going to do it as far as tricks.
So let's see what Nato's got right now.
So two tricks out for Hilario.
Oh, back mo 5, but it's not going to count. That's really bad.
So, yeah, that's right. It is too bad, but he's got solid scores right now. But
Neto with a crashed again on the Slim 7.
It is down to the wire. This is the witching moment right here. It is going to be a very close heat. Basically, Neto needs just one more point.
And 1 minute left. Come on, Neto.
So less than a minute. If he lands this next trick, I think Neto is going to continue his climb up the ladder to meet Christoph Tack. If not, it's going to be Robinson Hilario. And that could have done it right there.
Oh, he's already gone a few kgb. I still think Robinson's got the lead.
That's right. If that was not as good as his...
And that's the end.
...other kgb's, it's
yes,
going to be it.
I think Robinson might have this one.
Waiting for that other KGB, and it looks like he does have some higher scoring KGB, so I don't think that's going to do it for him. So right now, what I'm seeing with
I think we got Robinson.
I think we might have Robinson finals. Hilario, Dominican.
Awesome.
Into the finals. Let's wait to confirm that, as I've definitely made the wrong call numerous times. If you've watch this stream before. There's lots of mistakes I sometimes make, but we're still waiting for this KGB. Basically, what's happening is he did that last trick was a repeated trick, and if it was better than the KGB, any other KGBs that he did, it would increase his score. If it wasn't as good as the other KGBs, then his score stays the same. And
but
right now,
it'd have to be a pretty good KGB though, because Robinson. Actually, no.
I mean, right now they're at 32.71 to 33.44.
Very close.
Very close. Gonna wait to confirm that. In the meantime, take a breather because I'm just sweating bullets here from that last heat right there. Dominican and Brazilian heat. Just too close to call, but I think there's a good chance that it's gonna be Robinson Hilario advancing. As you can see, the camera is on him walking up the beach.
I think he's got this one.
I think he does too.
Yes, I see him
and
very happy.
That's it. It's a Dominican.
Dominican in the finals.
Moving through. Congratulations to him. We've got our women's heat coming up right next. Helena Beats is standing on deck, so we'll be back here for our men's final after this women's heat. Don't go anywhere. All right, and we're back. Yellow flag up means just less than a minute. Helena Beats, you're such a good sport, helping out the competitor who's going up against your boyfriend in the next heat.
I'm not helping out anyone except for Gisella, my teammate, because it's a teamwork over here. So, yeah, I missed one heat holding your kite up.
Just admit it, you're a nice person.
I don't know, really.
Sometimes
to be
I
honest.
Wonder.
Yeah, no, I'm trying. I'm trying my best.
Wow, pretty solid heat right there, huh?
Yeah, well, Hilario was throwing down. Like, his kites was like right above people, spectators' heads. Like, I thought he's gonna freaking chop someone's head off with the lines at some point.
Well, you know what? They were in the wrong place.
Gotta keep it low.
Keep it low. So on deck, we've got our ladies.
Angie Zella starting. I missed the first trick. Not very good.
I missed it as well. But we are hoping for another banger heat like we saw from Carolina in the past. I'm hoping for a banger heat from Gisela like we should know she's capable of. But it's going to be a challenge if Carolina is riding like she was in the single elimination.
Yeah, this last heat with a huge back mob and a KGB. That is crazy. And she's going for...
Nice trick from Carolina already. Something from Gisela down in the box into the sun. Bit of a challenge.
All right, we have Carolina coming back to the inside. See what she's got. She has pretty sick kites. They're like pink and blue. Custom fuels.
The Cookie Monster
kite. Cookie Monster kite, yeah. Forgot about it. I think they're cute. Oh, Toby is getting slammed by some waves out there.
Oh, my God.
The kickers
are...
Toby is getting some swell on him.
So shocked.
And Carolina with the Esmond blind.
Whoa. Nice kite.
Nice one. Kite a little bit high,
but
it still was a pretty clean one.
We'll probably see that one again.
And Gisela with the NIS. Oh. She's got it. Pretty good one as well. And Carolina on her way out. There are some kickers. Maybe she's going to use one.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a...
Back to blind from Carolina.
And that's a good thing for our next heat as well. I know someone else who likes kickers. As Gisela is setting up for something.
Gisela with the S-bend. She sent her kite a little bit too high, and that's why she got off balance. She's going to just go for it again. There's still plenty of time in this heat.
There is plenty of time in this heat. That's right. Here, as we are watching our women battle for first and second place already, this is the women's final for the double elimination. Basically, if Gisela beats Carolina here, she's going to have to beat her again to take her down.
Yeah, Carolina scored pretty nice for that last S-mob. It was like 6.5, I think it's going to be. It's pretty good.
Oh, nice.
She's crashing.
S1 from Gisela.
What is this jet ski doing in the middle of the zone? I mean, making chop right there.
I know.
Go away, man.
What are you thinking? There's
he's following her. He's stalking her.
I think he's got one of these Sony cams on his
and
helmet.
And Gisela, Carolina with the back move again. Was pretty good one. Not as big as the previous one, but still like really solid one. Pretty cool to watch. No, this jet ski should just go. What is happening? Look at that guy. He's just jet ski racing in a box.
I think he's the safety crew, but he thinks he's getting footage on his helmet cam or something.
Maybe he's like riding with a GoPro or something.
A little far, buddy.
Carolina getting close to the shore. Gisela in the middle of the box right now.
Oh, nice.
Splungers 3 from Carolina.
Ending that one pretty solid for Carolina. We've got some scores coming in already. 12.87 or 97 for Gisela Pulido. 28 for Carolina Winkowska. Pretty big spread right now. Carolina's
quite a big lead right now.
Nice. Definitely in the lead.
But Gisela still has some time to catch up.
Probably about a minute or halfway through
Gisela
this heat.
Gisela crashing again, unfortunately. And Carolina is catching some height. She's going a little bit upwind. It's like, as I said, like once you get stuck in the short break, it's sort of really hard to get out of there. So you need to watch out for that. With Gisela is now on the beach. She's going to take some time to get upwind. But anything can happen, so we'll see. Karolina coming in, stealing the stage right now.
Oh, Karolina catching the top side edge going down.
Good, bad edge catcher. But she's still in both boots. I mean, we've seen worse edge catchers this competition, ooh, eh?
I think Neto's heat comes
out of
to
both
mind.
Of them. Yep.
Yesterday, just got yanked out of both of his boots on his first trick.
And that was a final, so that's not a good time to jump out of your boots.
We are down to the wire with both these ladies. NIS from Caroline Wankowska there getting down to the wire. She's securing a nice lead here in front of Gisela Pulido. So Gisela really has her work cut out
Gisela
for her. I'm not sure
to
if she's
going to
have
for
enough time.
But I'm not sure either. But let's hope she can still throw one.
I'd like to see some big tricks thrown down.
There's still some time.
There is some time.
2 minutes, I think, in this heat left. Oh, no, it's actually 1 minute only. So she will have to really throw something decent.
Really big.
Something big,
I mean,
yeah, because right now Gisela is, Karolina is on a pretty big lead with 30.17.
Yeah.
And Gisela with only 12.87.
Ooh, oh, Karolina going down.
Some bad slams today.
But she's been riding strong, as is reflected in her points right now. Almost a 20-point difference between these ladies, so that's pretty.
And a 100 burger from Gisela, but she unfortunately crushed that one. So I think that heat is a wrap, pretty much.
Yeah, pretty much down to the wire.
Red flag should be up any time right now.
And you know what that means? It means she's going to keep her first place.
Oh, something is happening there. Okay, something happened because judges are screaming, but we cannot see because the tree.
Well, I think Gisela might have
hurt
herself.
I think something is wrong. Oh, yeah.
We can see.
Oh, no. I think she's not all right.
Our race director running towards the beach, getting her disconnected. Hopefully she is.
Hopefully she's fine, but it doesn't look good.
Might have gotten her bell rung a little bit on that landing. It was pretty far downwind for us to see anything here.
Yeah, we didn't see it. It was unfortunately behind it. Well, unfortunately.
But she's getting her.
It doesn't look that great. We see some people helping out. I think they're trying to get her out of the boots. Oh, it's not looking good, to be honest.
Well, we can only hope that Gisela is fine, as there's some folks helping her out of her boots and hopefully getting her.
There's a lot of people involved. I think she released her kite, so. Yeah, the competition is on hold right now because we don't know what's up with Gisela.
Not sure. Well, all you guys at home, it looks like
she's getting carried out of the water.
She's getting. At least she's not. She's walking, right?
She's sort of walking, yeah.
Okay, well, that's a good sign for sure that she's getting some help and getting walking on her own out of there. So not sure what happened right there in that last heat with Gisela Pulido.
Right, I'll go check on her.
But thanks, Elena.
I'll leave you guys for the guys' final. So
all right.
Enjoy.
Well, all right.
I'm going to check on Gisela.
Well, we've got the women's action winding down. That was Miss Karolina Wankowska ousting Gisela Pulido. Gisela taking a pretty big hit down there at the bottom of the box later in that heat. Right in the final moment. So all you guys at home, send some well wishes to Gisela, as we definitely hope that she is okay. We'll kind of keep you posted as we know what's going on with that. And as you heard, the heat has been postponed for the time being. So we are going to wait and see what happened and give you a start time when we find out. So in the meantime, enjoy some images, and we're going to cut to a quick break. Don't go anywhere. Be back with more from Panama. All right, so we are back and in sequence, ready to get this next and potentially last heat under our belt and done with. Right there, you can see the blue kite. That's Robinson Hilario. Just climbed from third up to second place, and he's going up against that colorful kite is Christoph Tack from Belgium. So Dominican Republic versus Belgium.
And that's the start.
And that's going to do it. With these guys out on the water, I know Christoph's been basically relaxing, waiting.
From blind mode from Robinson, big one.
This is going to be a doozy for sure. Real quick, a little update from Gisela. She appears to be fine. Just went down really, really hard on a Hinderberger Moab and just wasn't moving for a bit. So good to know she is back and coherent. Hopefully she's all good and well. But the action right now is on the water with these two gentlemen. Christoph Tack, definitely no stranger to the podium in the past number of events, finishing third overall on the tour last year, really coming on strong. And then Robinson Hilario, first time back after a pretty big hiatus from the tour.
Having a great start.
Great start.
Christoph with a NIS with a grab. Robinson KGB with a grab. Not sure which one to cheer for here. One's my Liquid Force teammate. The other one's my Dominican teammate.
Oh, the struggles, the internal battles that we deal with on a daily basis as kiteboarders.
Christoph with a crashed it, and Robinson with an NIS 5.
Yeah, we're gonna see some big tricks going down from both these guys straight out of the gate. This is a no holds barred heat right now. Both these guys have the skills to win this one, and it is anyone's game. The heat is quite young, just less than a minute underway already. As we are here at 5:39 local time, Robinson Hilario coming in towards the judges' tower.
Robinson getting some good speed. I think he's going for his double S3. No, just an S3. Really special. Didn't
just
get that much height, though.
Barely got that thing around that last rotation. He might want to do that one again. Definitely landed it and is going to be scored fairly well for it. But did you get a chance to talk to him?
I went down there trying to warn him not to do so many, like, tricks. Oh, Robinson crashing on a double Hindenburg pass, and Christoph, I think, landed a back mode 5. Yeah, but I was trying to warn Robinson not to do too many, like, tricks, not really go on some simple ones like 3-1-3s or blind judge 3s, because you don't want to run out of trick attempts. Christoph, the nice chromo 5.
Already, Robinson's got 6 trick attempts down, so not even halfway through the heat, and he's done with half of his trick attempts, so clearly he didn't get the memo. We will have to see.
Big. Blind judge 7, but I mean 3-1-7, but not too clean. Pretty butt check that one.
And 6 trick attempts already for Christoph Tack as well. That chrome up 5 coming in really nice. High 7s, mid 7s.
That's a nice one. Christoph coming in.
Christoph definitely has some competition experience now, so I think he's in the mindset. I think he really knows. He's got a strategy in his head. Robinson looks so hungry. He might need to just breathe a bit and relax. He's got the skills for sure. He needs to put them together right now in these last remaining 4 minutes of this men's final heat. Robinson Hilario.
The blind judge 5.
Oh, there's
landed that nice.
A sick blind judge 5 from Tack down at
Robinson,
the bottom.
Double back 5. Nice. Not too clean, but
kite was little up, but definitely landed it.
Surprising. Normally he can do them with his kite really nice, low and powered, and have a little struggle with him here.
I think this one's just going to go down to the last minute, really.
Yeah.
Already, Robinson with a slight lead, I think.
Nice.
Still some tricks out, though. You can see Christoph Tack checking his watch. And these guys keep their eye on.
He's going, I think, for his Pete Rose. Yeah. Yep. Nice. Powered. Robinson.
Yeah, some
going kickers. For a kicker.
Whoa!
I don't even know what to call that.
I don't either. I'm not even sure. Was
I think that was like a toe-sided. Was that double back roll?
It was like a toe-side mower.
Oh, no, that's his new trick he's been telling me about. Like, there's not even a name for a trick he's kind of invented. He's going to leave the judges with kind of an
Interesting.
I wonder how much that one's going to get scored.
Well, he's got two more trick attempts. He's going to have to make them count as right now.
Robinson.
Still four trick left.
Blind judge.
Oh, powered. Stomping that. The judges really like that.
Yeah. One more trick, Robinson. Make this one good, man. Coming in powered. Oh, just a big 3-1-3.
Oh, slim.
Seven?
Seven from... Yeah. From Christoph, it is getting interesting, folks.
I think Robinson's done with all of his tricks. Right,
Robinson's
there.
Got one more as far I can see. Nope, that's it for Robinson. You're right.
And how?
And it was a crash. So basically, Robinson's done being scored at the moment, and there's still three trick attempts for Christoph to be that he can take advantage of. And right now, I don't think it's going to be enough for Robinson.
No, Christoph's in the lead.
Is in the lead. But there's still a few tricks out. There's still a Scromob 5 from Robinson to come in. And a Christoph. Blind Judge 3.
Oh, Blind Judge 7 landed that one. Not so clean. Robinson and IS 7. That one was also not that clean, but crazy big tricks going on right now.
Crazy big tricks at the bottom of the box here at the PKRA into the wee hours. The green flag's down. Less than a minute remaining here.
And that's the red flag.
Boom. That's going to do it with Christoph Tack and Robinson Hilario. Still waiting for some tricks to come in already right now. I'm seeing...
Christoph got a high score for that slim 7.
Yeah, I think... Man, it's kind of tough to call, but we're going to have to wait and see right now. Still a few tricks out. It's going to be a close heat, I think. Here down to the wire as
he got good scores for his blind judge 7 too. Actually, never mind. Wow.
Wow is right, as you can see. We've got some spectators joining us on the beach. It's the weekend here in it's just the start of the weekend here in Panama. Not sure what day of the week it is where you are, but here it's Friday. And it is just going to be a busy weekend here as we get a lot of people coming from Panama City and elsewhere to take part in this PKRA event and our second discipline, our top secret second discipline, which we'll probably reveal here coming up. Still waiting for these scores to come in from that last heat. So I'm just going to throw to a quick break and leave you guys hanging to find out who is going to be taking home the bacon in that last heat. Is it going to be a super final with Robinson Hilario winning, or will it be Christoph Tack keeping his position on first place podium? You'll just have to stick around to find out. Don't go anywhere. All right, guys. Thanks for being so patient and hanging in there with us. It's been pretty much an amazing day of action. Lots of things going on. And we've got results. If you haven't already seen them, then I'm going to tell you what's going on right now. There is no super final. It's going to be Christoph Tack winning that heat against Robinson Hilario and sealing the deal as the champion and first place podium finisher for the Panama PKRA Kiteboard World Cup here in Nitro City, Panama. Second place is going to Robinson Hilario from the Dominican Republic. Third place, Alexander Neto, is that right, Augusto? And fourth place to Mr. Aaron Hadlow. So congratulations to all of our finalists here. For the women, it's going to be Carolina Winkowska taking home the bacon, securing her first place finish, as well as second place went to second place for the women for Gisela. That's right. She's doing all right. She got a pretty big hit in her last heat right there. Third place going to Bruna, and fourth place, the surprise, going to Lammerts, taking down young Annabelle Van Vestrop. So congratulations to the young Miss Lammerts. She was riding stellar. So an amazing day of action and an amazing event, but there's more to come. So this is it for the double elimination, but we got a second discipline. So do stay tuned to Facebook and Twitter feed for all of the updates on when that's going to be going on. And we'll be sure to bring you the action. It's going to be a doozy. So Dave Tiberski from Panama signing off for the day. Thanks for being with us, and we'll see you next time.